father had a Randall knife, and my mother gave it to him when he went off to World War II, save us all from ruin. If you've ever held a Randall knife, then you know my father well. If a better blade was ever made, it was probably forged in hell. My father was a good man. He was a lawyer by his trade. And only once did I ever see him misuse the blade, and it almost cut his thumb off when he took it for a tool. That knife was made for darker things. He could not bend the rules. He let me take it camping one time on a Boy Scout jamboree, and I broke a half an inch off trying to stick it in a tree. And I hid it from him for a while, but that knife and he were one. He put it in his bottom drawer without a hard word one. And there it slept and there it stayed for 20 some odd years, sort of like Excalibur, except it was waiting for a tear. My father died when I was 40, could not find a way to cry. Not because I didn't love him, not because he didn't try. I'd cried for every lesser thing, whiskey, pain, and beauty, but he deserved a better tear. I was not quite ready. So we took his ashes out to sea and we poured him off the stern, through the roses in the wake of everything we'd learned. When we got back to the house, they asked me what I wanted. Not the law books, not the watch. I needed the thing he haunted. And my hand burned with a Randall knife. So there in the bottom drawer, and I found a tear from my father's life, all that it stood for.